Hi, my name is Leo Atreides, and I am a truth seeker. I would like to show you the reasons it is possible the Mona Lisa may have been painted in 3D. By this, I mean two paintings made side by side, and most likely by the same person. To find the truth in the matter, we have to leave personal thoughts and feelings at the door. To start with no bias and weigh the facts accordingly. To change the debate from subjective to objective. This is how we find the facts. This is how we find the real truth. So I will attempt to bring you only agreed upon and verifiable facts, but the facts of one can be debated by another. So this leaves a gray area similar to what painters call sfumato, a blending of colors with no real edge, a process utilized by Leonardo da Vinci and Vermeer. So with that in mind, I'll try to leave out my subjective thoughts until the end. So let's get ready and go down the rabbit hole. For this first video, I decided to condense and omit quite a bit to help keep it short and sweet. We'll go into more of the details in the second video. Let's start with the Mona Lisa copies and when they were discovered. On YouTube, the Mona Lisa channel, we find clues in the video Mona Lisa, Leonardo's earlier version. In 1913, Hugh Blaker discovers what is now called the Isleworth Mona Lisa. But due to columns and the unfinished background, it was heavily debated as to if it was done by Leonardo. But then later they find the columns matching a drawing by Raphael that is believed to have been made at the same time Mona Lisa was painted. And since this didn't match the original in the Louvre, it renewed the two Mona Lisas rumor and debate. Then, in September 2012, it was brought back out into the public with 8 years of scientific backing, like chemical analysis, and by people like research physicist John Asmus, who gave a pixel-by-pixel histogram analysis showing that they were virtually identical. He states a 90% probability that they were made by the same artist. Next, we look at a third version of the Mona Lisa. In 2012, scientists examined another Mona Lisa copy found in Prado, Madrid. And this Mona Lisa was discovered to have a similar background hidden underneath a black varnish that chemical analysis showed the varnish had linseed oil, an ingredient not used until the 1700s, much later than the original paint estimated. It is also discovered that underneath the painting to have the same corrections to the fingers and shoulders as the original, suggesting to historians that the two Mona Lisas were done at the same time and most likely by the same person. Then, in May of 2014, LiveScience.com published an article called "Did Da Vinci Create a 3D Mona Lisa?" where Claus Christian Carbon and Vera M. Heslinger showed some of their work from a 2013 publication called Perception. They share their evidence, which gives them reason to believe it's possible that Leonardo painted the Mona Lisa in 3D. They compare the original in the Louvre and the Prado Mona since the backgrounds were similar, suggesting it was created as a pair. They submitted the paintings to undergo the fast math lab stereo matching algorithm developed by Wim Abelos to show that depth perception was mathematically correlated and not just an illusion or a person's perspective. But this was not widely accepted and the issue was dismissed and is noted in Wikipedia. Now, we have three paintings that have some scientific backing and support by some historians that they were possibly made in the same time period, in the Leonardo school, and maybe by Leonardo himself. And we have scholars and historians agreeing upon the evidence that Leonardo has made versions of other great works, like the Madonna of the Yarnwinder and the Virgin of the Rocks. And we find Leonardo has a fascination with perception and leaves in his notes many studies on the eye. With a little search on the internet with keywords, Leonardo da Vinci, optics, binocular, perception, and you will see that this was a major focus throughout Leonardo's life. The next set of clues comes from Pascal Cott and his multiple spectral camera that reads differences in 13 different wavelengths. In the video, Secrets of Mona Lisa, he scans the original Mona Lisa in the Louvre. He finds hidden eyebrows, a larger Mona Lisa outline, a smaller smile, and X marks on eyes looking in a different direction. Some other findings are 12 hairpins, tiny rows of dots outlining the head, and more. And with all the differences in the hidden Mona Lisa, Pascal concludes the larger head was turned 14 degrees. Okay, so we have Leonardo da Vinci, a man that although never entering a school, became versed in many areas like anatomy, mathematics, engineering, and many more. He is often quoted as saying he learned from experience in nature. Leonardo was an artist, an inventor, a genius, and he made advances in too many areas to count. He made drawings of scuba equipment to explore the seas, to elaborate wings so he could fly through the heavens. He made self-propelled cars and self-supporting bridges. Leonardo also conceived of a gigantic lens to harness solar energy for the dyeing and tanning industry. Today, historians even believe that he came up with the idea of the telescope long before Hans Lippershey, the Dutchman who is credited with inventing the telescope in 1608. Leonardo wrote, "In order to observe the nature of the planets, open the roof and bring the image of a single planet onto the base of a concave mirror. The image of the planet reflected by the base will show the surface of the planet much magnified." We have multiple paintings believed to have come from the time and possible school of Leonardo. Also with evidence, Leonardo painted different versions of other paintings like the Madonna of the Yarnwinder and Virgin of the Rocks. We have the report from Carbon Klaus Christian with algorithm results showing the differences related to perception and depth. And we also have Pascal stating that underneath the original, there is a Mona Lisa with a 14 degree turn. Now, one last little clue that people have been missing is the columns. And even though they say the original doesn't have columns and never did because the canvas was never cut, there are hints of the base of columns on the original. The smallest of details, but the possible final clue. And the evidence suggests that not just one or two, but all three are possible originals. To make sure everyone knows what we are looking for, I want to give you a few examples of the differences that we look for in perspective to give you a 3D picture, and that this can be viewed in free 3D, also called cross view or X, and requires no viewer or glasses in order to see. If you would like to learn how it is easy to see 3D, you can find tutorial pictures and a video showing multiple methods at headscapes.com. There is the pyramid pictures and video that show when overlapped the pyramids do not come together or align. Yet when we separate and view with the correct eye, the images come together and the angles and lines merge into one. The second example is the flip style made popular as lenticular GIFs, which are pictures from different camera angles, and they not only give a depth feeling, but can be separated and made into a 3D picture. The other thing to note with this video is how the background changes dramatically while the subject's changes are minuscule. Okay, now I think we're ready for the evidence. I would like to show you that the differences in the Mona Lisas is not subjective with artistic interpretation, but are instead objective and made so one can align the differences into a 3D view of the artwork. What I did was cut out the background from the images, as there is much debate if there was a canvas or a real background. But I believe the columns were real objects at the time the Mona Lisas were painted. If we flip the images after scaling to match the lips and eyes, we see they are completely different, especially with the columns as reference. I also scrutinized the depth change cues, nose and fingers, to help determine the proper eye to picture alignment utilized in crossview, and then place the three pictures accordingly. And the amazing thing is, they can be seen in multiple 3D pictures as each painting pairs with the one next to it, and then the outer paintings will also align with each other as well. And last, we look at the hands and head close up to note the differences, especially in the lower hand and the nose area. but when viewed in cross, we see the differences merge into an aligned 3D object. And to help show the differences, we overlap and flip the hands as well. And in the end, we just might be looking at what Leonardo has been wanting us to see. That he found a way to capture the whole person in a painting. So, hopefully we've covered enough of the clues to pique your interest. If you're still unsure with the information given so far, then just wait for the second video. It'll cover much more and show other 3D examples made by Leonardo or his school. To help show your support, you can join my Easy to See 3D Patreon page, and for as little as $1 a month, you can get access to exclusive videos and a more in-depth look at the evidence. You also gain access to the free 3D video collection with many coming from previous events. Pictures can be seen on our Facebook page. And if you would like, you can purchase an Easy to See 3D viewer. As you can see, I have many varieties with the majority designed to help you learn and teach others CrossView. I'm confident that most can learn how to see without a viewer. It's only without a viewer that you can truly appreciate the crystal clear view you get with free 3D pictures and videos. And recently developed is the Keepsake Viewer that 95% can see the enclosed pictures pop into 3D. And it is also designed to help you start learning the crossing technique needed to see free 3D. So with all that to ponder, I leave you with a little song. Until next time.
I wanna help the world to see stereoscopic 3D. All you have to do is cross your eyes and see this world for free.
I'll see you soon.